Hey everyone, Kyle once again, and welcome back to another video and more on movie. Been a while, so back on movie news. So another vlog. So it's been a while since I did one, but this one got my attention because it's another damn shame. Well, I didn't know about this until I read more into it. But one of my commenters mentioned that. That Disney is now shutting down Blue Sky Studios. There's a show that, you know, since Disney owns Fox, you know, now they could just, Disney, they could just do whatever, you know. They just go, if a film doesn't like that, make them a good amount of money, then they're gone. Yeah, so yeah, Blue Sky Studios is shutting down because Disney is shutting down Blue Sky Studios. So if you're familiar, you know, if you're familiar with Blue Sky Studios, their well-known, their most well-known franchise, easily, is the Ice Age movies. Yes, so Blue Sky Studios, they made the Ice Age movies, and other films I liked. You know, they also did Rio 1 and 2, Robots, which I did like, because someone asked me like a couple years ago, do you see Robots? And I said, yeah, I've seen Robots. And it was good. It is good. Robots is a good movie. With good cast, you know, Robin Williams, you know, Drew Carey, Ewan McGregor, Mel Brooks. Robots was good. I said Rio 1 and 2. Ferdinand, which I reviewed a while back, which I said before, I'm not a fan of John Cena, but his voice was okay, right? But still. I did review Ferdinand. The Peanuts movie from 2015 I liked. Epic, which I viewed long ago, Epic from 2013. I wish I would have gotten a sequel. Animation was really well made. Let's see here. The last film, officially the last film they did was back in 2019. That was Spies in Disguise with Will Smith and Tom Holland, which I did see not that long ago, and I actually did like that movie. I did not mind Spies in Disguise. And also, Horton Hears a Who. Dr. Seuss's Horton Hears a Who with Jim Carrey and Steve Carell. I think I reviewed that long ago, I think, too, also. Can't remember. I look back at it. Did I review Horton Hears a Who? I don't think I did. It's been that long ago, so I probably don't remember. But yeah. And of course, like I said, the Ice Age movies. Which they did several Ice Age shorts. And of course, their mascot of the studio is Scrat. You know, the saber-toothed squirrel is always losing his acorns or his nuts. Yeah, he's the symbol of Blue Sky Studios. There's several shorts about him, which is on him stolen. There's some other Ice Age shorts too, holiday specials as well. I mean, Ice Age was easily their biggest profit. Well, franchise that was their biggest profit. They made the most money. Although Rio 1 and 2 was successful, while the second film surpassed the first film, made $500 million worldwide. And the other movies were critically praised as well. Like, Robots was a hit, and critically too. Same with Horton Hears a Who, the Peanuts movie, Epic. But Epic, it's the animation in Epic was, I would think, probably was the best of Blue Sky Studios. But, Ferdinand was nominated for an Oscar for animated movie, but probably because, you know, Spies in Disguise didn't do that well profitably, so maybe that's the reason. That was like, I mean, made over 77 worldwide, but domestically made 66 million on its budget of 100 million. So it technically didn't do that well. Although it did get some praise though, but. It just sucks, you know. I mean, this is a film that didn't do that well. I mean, because Disney owns every, Disney's a monopoly. They own practically everything, you know. So you can just decide which goes, what's not. Oh no, keep Pixar because that's their most massive thing in this for Disney, as well as Walt Disney Animation Studios. You know. The ones that did Wreck-It Ralph and etc., you know, at Walt Disney Animation Studios, not Pixar. Like, those are the biggest things, but they'll keep those because they make billions of dollars. So, but Blue Sky Studios, since they're owned by Fox and Disney owns it, that's it. Because Spies in Disguise didn't do that well. And by the way, they were in production making another movie called Nimona, which was 10 months had 10 more months left of production, but now they scrap that, you know. So, which I never heard Nimona. Apparently, it was a comic series from what, 2011 or 12. Look, it was about a shapeshifter who was teaming with a mad scientist, I guess. I never heard of Nimona, but it's too bad. It was gonna be released in 2022, but since they canceled it, so with 10 months left of production, stupid, you know. Like I said, they own it, Disney owns everything, so they can decide what comes and goes, basically. And yeah, and just looking by a spokesperson who told Deadline, said, given the current economic realities, after much consideration and evaluation, we had to make the difficult decision to close the filmmaking operations of Blue Sky Studios. So yeah, well, of course, because everything would have happened last year and still going on, you know. So yeah, that's one part that's understandable still. It just totally sucks, because yeah, I like the Ice Age movies, you know. Well, especially the first one, because I remember I first saw that back in 2002 in the theaters. It came out before my birthday in 2002, so I was basically 10 basically at the time. Yeah, I love the first Ice Age. I like Epic. Did not mind Ferdinand despite John Cena. But the Rio as well, Peanuts, Robots, like I said, I like, Horn Hears a Who. And I did not mind Spies in Disguise. It was not that bad. So yeah. It just totally sucks. It just goes to shows that Disney's I've lost all respect for Disney right as of right now, you know, for quite some time. Yeah, I like Toy Story 4. But that was in 2019. Yeah, I like Toy Story 4. But just because I like the movies doesn't mean I like the whole company as a whole, you know. So I'm sure a lot of people say the same way. Well, officially, because they're always buying up everything as well, being a big monopoly. I mean, to me, they made the mistake of buying the Star Wars movies, because to me, they ruined the Star Wars franchise. They bought those, and those are big disasters. I hate this sequel trilogy. I hate Force Awakens. I especially hate Last Jedi, and I hate Rise of Skywalker, and the shitty prequel of Solo, which was pointless, and I did not like Rogue One, another pointless prequel, or in-between movie. And now and it says they bought those, but they ruined that. And now they also ended up buying Fox. Now they own Blue Sky Studios, which they're shutting down. They own other franchises as well. They own the Alien movies. They own the Predator movies, which, I don't know. It's just too much. Disney's shows are just big. They're just being such big a holes, you know. Yeah, I know. Just because the last one didn't do that well doesn't mean that you just cut the umbilical cord altogether, basically. Whatever, but what do I know? I'm just a lonely schmuck here. So, but I'm sure the other people here that say the same thing. I'm sure there are fans of Blue Sky Studios are very disappointed as well. I'm not the only one. I'm sure other people are fans of the studio, but I'm sure they're very disappointed like I am. Well, I know I'm not saying we want another Ice Age movie because there's been 5 so far, but that's their biggest profit, you know. No, there are other films that made that amount of profit like the Ice Age film did, but I know there's a time this franchise needs to stop, though, but I don't know, what is this? I'm just going on and on about this. So, I mean, yeah, it says that they're coming to a close in April, so, hey, great, more jobs being laid off. What else is new? So yeah, so that's all I can say. It sucks. Disney just, you know, they just they own everything. They basically own everything. They want to take. They basically, you know, what comes and goes, so they can just cancel whatever. But no, keep Pixar and Walt Disney Animation Studios, because those they make their that's their biggest money makers. Well, I mean, well, yeah, I don't know, well, but. And Star Wars is never gonna go away, because their hit series The Mandalorian, Disney Plus. I don't own Disney Plus, and I don't want Disney Plus. I don't want anything from. I don't want to give any of my money to Disney right now, or probably never now. Yeah, I like Toy Story 4. Okay, I liked it though, but Disney Plus. I'm not gonna waste my money on Disney Plus. I'll wait for stuff to come out on DVD. If it takes stuff for a while to come out on DVD, that's fine. But I'm not gonna waste my money on Disney Plus. Because I don't think that place. I think that was a dumb place. I always thought that was a dumb thing to call Disney Plus. Plus what? See, I ain't giving my money and not even a penny to Disney Plus. I'm not giving my money anymore as of right now to Disney right now. So, yeah. If I want to give it to Disney, I'll give it like to the old, back when Disney was good, like from the 90s, maybe early 2000s, you know, or 80s. That's what I'll give to Disney, back when they were good. I'm sure a lot of people will say back when Disney was good, you know, from the 80s to the 90s, especially to the 90s, and I'll say I'll even give the early 2000s, like from 2000 to just curveballing, yeah, maybe 2008, 2009, I don't know. But yeah, but as of right now, I've lost all respect for Disney now. So they can buy up everything. I don't want to stop right now. Blue Sky Studios. I'm just going off topic because it just sucks because it's Disney. That's why. Blue Sky Studios is sucks. You know, we all like the Ice Age movies. Well, most of us do. So I'm sure some of us are not a fan of the sequels though. But the other films, Epic, Robots, Ferdinand, Rio 1 and 2. Like I said, Spies in Disguise was not that bad of a movie. I did not mind it. It blows. That's what I'm saying. It blows. Yeah, so enough ranting on about this. But thanks for watching, and just... If anyone's fed up with Disney, I completely understand. I am absolutely fed up with Disney. I'm tired of Disney now. I'm not giving any of my money to Disney Plus. No. Yeah. So, but I'm sure some people will agree with me, or otherwise we disagree. That's what we do. We agree to disagree. We're either right or wrong. It's all subjective. So, but yeah, you let me know what you think. Just leave your comments down below. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned for the next video. Later.